Hello, 3D printing friends. There's a new Pet G in Bamboo Town. It's called Pet G HF, and it's supposed to print as easily as PLA. And we'll get a closer look at it right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hi, welcome back. Okay, so today we're getting a look at Bamboo Lab's new Pet G HF filament. This new filament replaces Bamboo Lab's now discontinued PETG Basic. Thanks to Bamboo Lab for sending a few spools of this over so we could play with it. So what is PETG HF? Well, it's PETG, and the HF presumably stands for high flow. The product page says that it's designed for high-speed printing and effectively addresses oozing and clumping. Offering greater durability and toughness than PLA, PETG HF is ideal for creating long-lasting items. It's supposed to be as easy to print with as PLA, but Bamboo Lab recommends drying it before use and keeping it dry. With PLA, you generally just unbox it, unbag it, load it up, and start printing. And since I was excited to start using it now, I skipped the drying step and printed a big model. Now, when that part finished, I printed a benchy, and then I dried the filament and printed a benchy again so we can compare the before and after print quality to see if drying is really necessary. To dry it, you can use a dedicated purpose-built filament dryer, or if you have an X1 series printer, you can dry it using the printer's filament drying mode. And that's where you put the filament on the bed, cover it with the filament box to hold in the heat, and the printer uses the bed as a heating element to dry the filament. It runs on a timer and shuts the bed off again after several hours. It's a cool feature, so if you have an X1 series, it's sort of like getting a filament dryer for free. The filament is super new, and it looks like there may be an issue or two related to this new product rollout, but I expect that it'll be resolved soon. First, it looks like it's the same price as their discontinued regular PETG filament. At least it is for the refill rolls. Now, what's a refill? Well, Bamboo Lab filament comes on reusable spools. They twist apart, and then you can load in a refill. Their regular PETG is $23 with a spool and $20 without a spool. Since the refills cost $3 less than the same filament already on spools, the refills represent about a 13% savings. So anyway, based on the fact that the refills of both PETG and PETG HF cost $20, I'm expecting that the price of the PETG HF on a spool will be that same $23 amount they charge for the regular already on a spool PETG. But at the time of recording, the PETG HF filament is only available as a refill. Now, given that I received the filament on a spool, I'm guessing that Bamboo Lab just needs to add the with spool version to the product page. The second issue is that, and again, this is at the time of recording, despite the spools having RFID tags that are supposed to identify the material type and color, neither the printer's AMS unit nor the Bamboo Studio slicer seemed to know what the PETG HF is. I did make sure to update the X1 Carbon and its AMS to the current firmware, and I updated Bamboo Studio to the current version, but that didn't make a difference, at least not at first. But I'll come back to that in a moment. Hey, if you're getting value from this video, a subscribe would really make my day. That lets me know I'm making content you enjoy and you want to see more like it. Thanks. So I just mentioned that after updating the printer and AMS firmware to the current version and updating Bamboo Studio to the current version, it still didn't know about the PETG HF filament. So I manually set those AMS slots to Bamboo Lab PETG Basic. Spoiler alert, at some point after printing this project, Bamboo Studio and the printer gained awareness of PETG HF. But this project was printed using the regular PETG settings because, again, that's all I had at the time. What is this project? This is the Cooler Cube. This was designed by Make3D, and there's a link to it in the description. This is one of the models featured on the product page, and I thought it would be a fun print. Load 4 cans of your favorite beverage, add some ice cubes or crushed ice, and it'll keep those cans as cool as it, can. Now again, this is printed with the filament fresh out of the bag and not dried before use, as Bamboo Lab recommends. The big red base of the cooler took a little over 13 hours to print. The little blue hinge accents took about half an hour, and the white handle took about an hour. And I'm just going to come out and say it. With the exception of the handle printed in white, I'm not super impressed with the fresh out of the bag print quality on this. It's functional, but it's not as pretty as I was expecting. But hindsight is, as they say, 20/20. And so next, I'll show you a dried versus not dried test print. So in light of the print quality I got on the Cooler Cube, I wanted to see the difference in print quality between not dried filament and dried filament. So I printed a 3D Benchy in the red PET GHF. This is the fresh from the bag, not dried before use, used for 13 hours in the AMS unit filament. And the result, like the main part of the Cooler Cube, isn't great. But I needed a Benchy baseline, and this is it. It took an hour to print. There's a lot of pits and zits on the surface, and it's generally not a good result. Then I dried the filament for about 12 hours and printed the same file again. And again, it took an hour to print, but this time it came out a lot better. There are still a few pits, but it's a much cleaner looking print. I mentioned earlier that at some point the printer, AMS, and slicer gained awareness of the PET GHF filament. So I took advantage of that and sliced and printed a third Benchy. It looks pretty much exactly like the dried before printing Benchy I just showed you, but it only took 50 minutes to print instead of 60. So with the correct settings, PET GHF prints faster than PET G. 10 minutes may not sound like much, but on a 1 hour print, that's almost 17% of the total print time. I also re-sliced the body of the Cooler Cube to see what the print time would be with the correct filament settings. Bamboo Studio says it would print in 11 and a half hours instead of a little over 13. So the PET GHF settings would cut about an hour and 45 minutes off the print time. Now I would have printed the body of the Cooler Cube over again, but it uses more than half the spool, so I wouldn't have had enough filament to do it. So that's my first look at Bamboo Lab's new PET GHF filament. Drying the filament before printing is less of a suggestion and more of a requirement. It does print faster than regular PET G. Once the filament has been sufficiently dried, it seems to print quite nicely with a matte appearance and little stringing. Now, really the only thing I perceive as an issue with it is the dry before use requirement. It would be nice if it was dried at the factory before being vacuum sealed and shipped. Then you could treat it like PLA and just unbox it, unbag it, load it, and start printing. It should stay dry in the AMS unit, and you could always dry it later if it needed it. But having it dry from the get-go would be a lot more convenient. Well, thank you for watching, and big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool. Cube.